one of the most important parts of making a boat run well, and indeed to have a crew perform, is to make sure that each stroke the boat is not checked, particularly at the catch. So athletes coming into the catch and checking the boat is a common way that boats slow down, and if you lose that much every stroke, then by the time you get to the end of a race, of course, then you probably haven't won it. So what this short session of videos is about how you can, as a coach, demonstrate to the athletes what's important, make sure that they understand what you're trying to achieve by making sure you've got the blade well placed and connected with the water before you drive, and then a couple of tips from an athlete on how to practice on an ergo, practice picking up the catch and making sure that you've got connection before you push, and then doing the same thing on the water. Then there's a video there of how, as a coach, you can follow an athlete in the speedboat and use the speedboat to help make the athlete understand what's going on with checking of it, together with another tip from another coach about how you can do it using essentially a spanner and a stick. So I suggest you watch these videos, understand them well, and make sure that when you're talking to the athletes that it's very important that they have connection at the catch before they have the leg drive. I'd suggest also that they should come into the catch gently and without putting any pressure on the foot plate at all, so be really careful to avoid pressure on the foot plate until they drive with their legs. Now, I understand that a very experienced crew, for example, Olympic level elite athletes, it is possible to come into the catch pulling the boat towards you with your legs, place the blade and then drive immediately and get a bit of extra speed out of that technique. The issue with that with junior crews, and indeed most crews, unless they're very good at that placement at the catch and that timing of the connection, then I'd suggest they're more likely to slow the boat down than not. So with a very good crew, by all means give it a go, but for the bulk of athletes out there, I'd suggest gentle into the catch, get well connected, then with the leg drive. So I hope these videos are of use.
I would say about that much of your slide, that last bit running into the catch, I could, like, the boat was running, if I, this is your stern, the stern's running, and then I just pull up and then I go. Now in a good eight, in a good boat all round, that should just run. Right, so that, if, and that, what's the most important thing? What's it all about?
The boat.
The boat. Hmm. So if your boat's doing that, you've got to find out a way to make it keep running. Because if you think, as you're coming into the catch and it's pulling up, it's not only pulling up, you know, that much into your catch, it's, you're also losing that into the stroke. So, you know, you got to make that turn that negative into a positive. So you got to be running in continuous to pick it. That's where that timing of the placement and the press is critical. That's where your boat slows up, and if you don't get it right, it slows up even more. So it's even worse. So you got to try and nail that so you get it right.
Where does the power phase start? You know, if you think, you know, you're coming up here, and how often do you see that before the blade's actually in the water? You've already rode the stroke through and the legs are on, and then the blow goes in. That's useless. So it's got to be there, relaxed drop, then it's on. All right, and that's what we're trying to achieve. So it's not a hard, tense catch. And that's what you, what, you know, you feel when in that movement, you feel up in the stern end, because it's, you know, it's been taken off them because everyone's already rowing it in. You know, so it's got to be a drop and on. And then when we talk about timing it, the place and the press, that's what it is, relax, bang on. That's that, blade in, execute the hips and the legs on. They're on, all right? That's what we're trying to achieve, really.
Okay, what we're trying to do is to get the feel of the catch where you have the tension loaded on at the same time as your seat moving back. So you don't want your seat to move or your body to go back before you have the tension on the chain. You want it to happen all at the same time. So you practice just small movements where you're getting the feel of it all together.
1 foot.
And then you swap legs. Do the same thing. Try both legs. I felt good going straight from doing it on the ergo to doing it on the water, but I couldn't really feel what I'd changed until I tried to do it badly again and do it incorrectly. And then when I fixed it, I could feel what I was meant to be doing.
And what was that?
Getting the connection right from the catch and not letting it slip before you push. When the coach comes up to you in the boat when you're rowing along and trying to get the catch right, you can see it because you're relative to something. So if you get the catch wrong, you've got to come closer to the boat at the catch because you're going to stamp on the boat and it's going to move the wrong way. And if you get it right, you should just stay in line with them. So you can use it as something to work off.
How close should the boat be to you?
The weight coming off the side of the boat should be like just nearly at your stern, so that if you do push backwards, you go into it and you can really tell because it slows you down.
6 metre length of conduit, to hang it out off the bow of the boat, and it's got a spanner hanging off the end of it on a rope. I get right behind him and just hang it over stern of his skull. He's got to make sure that the stern of his boat doesn't come in underneath the spanner that's hanging off it. Pull away, if anything. He knows that if the stern of his boat's coming back in, he's doing something to check the boat.
Outside hand back on your hip again.
No delay.
Feel for that water, make sure you get that catch really smooth, no jerk in the boat. When I coil, we'll put the outside hand back on again, so take it off your hip and back onto the oar. On this one, maintain that same smoothness around the catch, making sure you pick the water up, pick it carefully before you drive, so we don't end up with that jerk in the boat. Much better, much smoother.
That last piece of footage of an exercise in an eight to improve the catch is a very useful one for using in any sweet boat, and I commend it to you.
The general purpose, of course, is to have a powerful drive phase, let the boat run, and don't cheese it off on the way down. So gently into the front, making sure you have no weight on the foot stretcher, and in fact have the blade going into the water before you actually apply any weight to the foot stretcher. If you do that, then you'll find that the stern of the boat doesn't dip at all, or very little, and the boat just gets picked up and runs again. So the stern of the boat will have this sort of a movement, rather than this sort of a movement. And it's really important to be able to grasp that, because you'll find if they get that, then the rowing simply becomes a lot easier. Additionally, you'll find that it's easy for them to do that at a slower rating, so if they can do it at 20, then the challenge is being able to do it at a higher rating. And if they get up and they can do it at, say, 32, 33, then you'll find you've got a very fast boat indeed for the power of the athlete. The easiest way to build it up is to gradually work it up, work the rating up, and getting the same level of competency at each level as they go up. Often you'll find they can do it well at rating 20, 22, but as soon as it comes to doing it at 28 or 30, you'll find that the boat's getting stopped each time they come to the catch. In essence, they're pushing the boat backwards with their feet before they've got their blade in the water.
Just a couple of final thoughts on how to encourage athletes to understand coming into the catch very gently. A few different ways of describing it which may make sense with some of your athletes. One is, as they're coming down the slide, I'd suggest that they come off the back, they get their body over into the catch position, and they get to about halfway down the slide, and then just ask them to stop and just let the boat move with them. Another way of describing it is, as they're coming down the catch, watch the paddle that's going away from them from the previous stroke and try and match their body speed down the slide to keep with that paddle, which again means they're moving with the speed of the boat. A couple of other thoughts of maybe of use, ask them to pretend that there's an egg underneath their feet, and as they're coming into the catch, they don't want to break that egg until they've got the blade in the water. Another one, as they're coming into the front, imagine there's a layer of air underneath their feet and they're not going to touch it. So just don't touch that foot stretcher until you get there. I suggest also ask your athletes what works for them. So what words make sense to them in relation to understanding this concept? Because if they get this concept to work, then you'll find that their boats will generally go a lot faster with a lot less effort, because they're not checking the boat every time. So hope that's of value and enjoy. Thank you.